Hello everyone. So thank you for this great opportunity. So I am really impressed about this conference. I see all this virtual room, a lot of people around there, and a beautiful view inside this conference area. So I am really impressed that I can join the SoftCom conference. Damian Hoffman, I am a senior system engineer at FireEye. So FireEye, maybe some of you know, we are a security company. We are covering a lot of the vectors which can prevent such kind of the really complex advanced attack into your network, into your email, into your endpoint. And we are trying to get you the tools to get right incident response, right hunting tools, just to be sure that no attackers are inside in your network. But good news for today, this is that it will be like a not product presentation. So it will be, I will only base on some kind of the facts. So FireEye with Mandiant. Mandiant, this is our consulting company and service part of the FireEye. We publish some kind of the reports with a security validation. And today I would like to share it with you because about this validation, I am pretty sure it will be like the hottest topic for the next year and this year for sure, because of like our environment, network environment, endpoint environment, workstation are becoming more and more complex. And you are probably, if you are a customer, you have a lot of the budget to spend. Maybe you spent some kind of the hryvnias in the past to invest into your security. And now the question to you is how to check it, yeah? So how to check your investment into security? It is the proper way. Do you have some kind of the internal measurement like total cost of ownership, so TKO, or maybe ROI, return on investment? So probably you have some kind of the measure to just check if the security really works. Maybe it's a investment into your organization, not only a cost. So I appreciate if this situation will occur. So all of this metrics can show you is that the security is your value. And as far as I know, because in the past I was working as a technical manager for one of the biggest energy company in Poland, and I am especially sure that you are getting such kind of the question like this, maybe from your CIO, maybe for your board level, maybe for your manager, maybe for your chief, maybe from another part of technical resources we got it to your team. Someone can ask, is this you really, our organization is secured, or maybe we are can be prepared for such kind of the attack. And on the other side, you are on the SOC level specialist, you are on the security level specialist. So for sure, your organization spent like maybe this or maybe this amount of the money for the security. Yeah. So if your organization and if your manager is sure that this budget is spent on the right way, are you concerned about this? And on the other side, some of the people into your organization can ask you how you can reduce your cyber security risk in your organization. And this question can be obvious in some way. Maybe someone will ask you about some kind of the critical of your system. So do you have the definition of the critical system? Do you know what is the most critical system in terms of maybe data leakage, in terms of your proper the intelligence and intellectual property in your organization? So we count on this information. As a FireEye and Mandiant, we publish a security validation report. So in this report, we try to find what are the trends in the validation, what are the trends in the validation means that they're checking your security. Yeah. So you have some security stack, you have some security investment, and how to check it, how to validate, is it work proper? Maybe this is better idea not to invest a lot of the money and new money for the new products into the security, and be sure that I am saying about it. So I am a representative of the vendor, but maybe you have to invest this money for example, for improve your existing security stock. Yeah, invest for the people just to train them and to use and better use the existing security stock. And this is the open question. And on this report, we're trying to answer it for such kind of the question. So we have like three not positive. So that is why I'm sharing this kind of the facts. So they are not positive because we see that a lot of the security companies have to do in the future. Maybe some kind of the definition in the beginning of this report, because on the right side of the screen, you see the words like missed and alerted, detected, prevent. So missed in our reports and our thinking means that we do not prevent and do not detect and do not alert some kind of this security breaches. Alerted means that there is some kind of the alerts on the system, but this is not the source from the security system, but it's more like CMO, there is some kind of the log about the attack. Detects, this is the higher level. So it means that we detect the attack. So in our security systems, there's a big alert, there's some kind of the summary, and there are the IOC, which we can say that we are pretty sure that we detect this kind of the attack. And of course, the highest level of your security maturity is that you can prevent the attack. Yes, so you detect it, you alert it, and on the other side, you have some kind of the security stack, security environment, just to cut, for example, the malicious traffic, or maybe block the attacker from your network. And the first statistic is that, unfortunately, above 67 of the attacks which we analyzed in the Mandiant and the FireEye were not prevented. Yes, so this is like very important information that there is still a gap investment into your security. On the other side, there's a higher number, so it's like a worse information that above like 74% of the attack were not detected. Yeah, so in terms of the security systems, in terms of the your SOC operating system, you are blind, so you are typically not see such kind of the attack. And when we go a little bit drilled down into the detection, you will see that the next statistic. And this is really, I think that you should remember this number and think about your security approach into your organization, that only the 9% of the attack, so remember like 100 of the attack, and only 9 of those attacks are alerted on the CM. And probably if you have some standard CM products into your organization, you can imagine that there's millions of the hryvnia investment, for example, in the CM. So I think that like a new modern approach to the security, for sure. So some kind of the statistic and recommendation for you is to think about it. Is it this money worth to invest in the CM? Or maybe there are other, some kind of validation tool or maybe improvements tool into the security, which can be better invest this money into the security. So first of all, I would like to remember this number. This is only the 9% of the attack, according, of course, to our knowledge, according to analyzing above 100 different type of the environment, also in the Europe, also in the East Europe region, we based on those statistics to create such kind of the report. And in the end of my presentation, I will share the link how you can by free download this report, maybe to think better about the security and some statistic into the validation. So based on these facts, we see like three trends. So this is not a big trends, but these are some kind of the macro trends which I would like to share. And this is also based in my experience, because whenever I see, I am situated and work usually in Poland, but also regionally in Ukraine and other Adriatic and Balkan countries. And I see that there's a trend to the migration of the cloud. Yeah, and probably you heard it like from many, many times from different type of the vendors that, yes, we know we are migrating into the clouds, but this is the real challenge, not a migration to the cloud, but a cloud misconfiguration and cost enterprise like this amount of the money. This is trillion, so the money is probably you cannot imagine. But based on the Dive Cloud report on the bottom of the presentation, you can find a source for it. Based on this, you are sure that this is not in terms of the migration to the cloud, but the real problem is the misconfiguration of the cloud. Yes, so you have to get some kind of the additional tool, for example, when you are in the process of the migrating, to validate, to check if this migration going on the right way or maybe in the bad way. Yeah, do you have some kind of the Roy, do you have maybe some kind of the counters which can measure how you can are good implementing to the cloud? So this is the one trend. The second, and especially in my career, I can like 100% true, this is the responsibility into your organization. Yeah, so when I compare it to a different type of the customer, the in your environment, there's always like a little bit fight between the IT environment and between the security environment. Yeah, so usually IT team controls the organization asset and trying to, for example, create a virtual machines for you as a security, create an IP address and stuff like that. But in terms of the security of the organization, you are responsible for those assets because you're responsible for the security. And for example, in terms of the many cases like data leak, you as a security are responsible for this kind of the asset, not the IT. So there's always a little bit conflict, and it will be also a good information to you that you will have some kind of the tools to measure the security in terms, for example, on the IT asset. And the first statistic, I am pretty sure that you are also familiar with it. And when you see these shortcuts like IPS, firewalls, antivirus, like privilege access management, identity access management, and maybe some kind of the database firewall, APT systems, for example, like FireEye have, or web application firewall, a lot of the stuff like that. I am pretty sure that some of the shortcuts, you know, maybe all of them. So it's really good information for you that it's a really good security SOC member or security team manager. But when you count also and imagine that probably in the last career or maybe in your previous company, your existing or previous, invest like a hundred of millions of hryvnia into this security environment. And the bad news is that all of this environment, all of these security tools usually have separate console. Yeah, and this is not a good information to you. You have separate console. So a lot of the SOC people have a different type of the console. And do you have some tool to measure it? What is the descendants and what is the dependence between those environment? Or maybe you have like one single SOC console to manage it. This is always, I think that some kind of the issue, some kind of the challenge, of course, for you to be aware of it. Yes. So too many security controls and too many security GUI, too many secure environment into your organization can prepare and can create a little bit mesh in terms of the, for example, organization or in terms of the administration of those tools. So these are those three trends. Now let's switch to the deep dive layer. Let's go for some real data which we covered into this report. So as FireEye on the market, we know that the advanced malware attack, this is not a one part of the attack, but it's like five or six different stage of the attack. Yes. So first of all, when the attacker trying to target your organization, this is not like unpredictable, but he's trying to be very, very prepared to you. So he's doing some kind of the reconnaissance. Yeah. Maybe reconnaissance of your domain on the Google, maybe trying to find a direct email address, or maybe doing a reconnaissance of your network segmentation. Yeah. Maybe some ports are open, extended. Maybe he tried to scan your external environment and external network, maybe web portals. So this is like in many, many cases, we see that there's a missed gap, that there's a gap in the network segmentation of the misconfiguration. Yeah. So the attackers in the reconnaissance phase trying to show to use such kind of the gap. So it's always for you as a customer to be known that such kind of the statistic and such kind of the reconnaissance phase, it's occur in many type of the attacks. So on the other side, on the security side, it's good to have some kind of the tool to measure the misconfiguration on the policy, on the proxy, on the firewalls, or maybe on the VLAN, on the network level. And we see the statistic that 54% of the attack are missed in this reconnaissance phase. On the other side, the second phase is if the attacker do a reconnaissance of your network, this is the malicious file transfer. So probably you all know that the attacker trying to use phishing, maybe attacker use trying to put some kind of the pen drive in your like small branches somewhere in the Ukraine. And he's always used the misconfiguration, yeah? Misconfiguration of the security control system, which now you have, yeah? So you have to be sure that those systems are create like in the correct and good way, a proper way. So whenever you have like an APT, advanced security systems, maybe it's a sandbox, maybe it's something more advanced, like for example, FireEye have, but there's always a case, a challenge into your organization to the better and try to be sure that this is an in the good configuration. And we see that half of the attack was okay because of this misconfiguration of your existing security devices. Yeah, not a new devices which you are planned to implement, but your existing security devices. On the other hand, I always recommend you like to go for some external framework. Like for example, Mitre on the right side of the screen, you have some kind of detected which you based on this kind of the a statistic command and control. This is a usually use case when attacker trying to connect to the command and control after the malware is inside into the network. And maybe it's because of the lack of SSL inspection. And maybe this is because of this, remember the 9% of the attack visible into the CM? Maybe it's not because of you have CM, but the CM is like in the bad configuration. Yes, yeah? So you have to be sure also about it. On the other side, be sure that there are some kind of the next phase of the attack. So phase of the attack like lateral movement. So for example, the guy, the hacker is inside into your network, but he's not on the administrator computer, but he's on some on the station with the with your branch, for example, in Kharkiv, yeah? So he tried to move to your headquarters, to Kiev, to get, for example, the admin credential for the most valuable user, for some finance department, for some director, and maybe, of course, in the final stage of the attack for the credential of the active directory administrator in the root account. So this is also some kind of the problem in internal of the security, lack of the misconfiguration, lack on the network monitoring traffic on the some way, because you are not monitoring this lateral movement. Lateral movement means that the attacker is hoping from one side to another of the network, maybe trying to switch from one user, use the PowerShell to use, for example, the stolen credential and move to another account. So there's a lot of the tools can support it. Of course, one of it is the fire endpoint security, but this is, I don't want to focus on the products on this presentation. And the last MITRE framework and the last attack, which I would like to share, this is the data exfiltration. And in terms of your brand on the external sources, this is quite of the most important, because in this phase, the attacker, what is trying to do? Steal some kind of the information, yes? Steal, so maybe your personal data with some RD, with some name and surname and address, and some maybe tax numbers or maybe your telephone numbers, and trying to, for example, sell it on the darknet. On the fire, we see the statistic that, for example, in Poland, one record for the one person can be sell on the darknet in the price of above $100 per one person. So remember what is the price which can attacker get on the darknet when, for example, he's still like the database with the 10,000 of users. Yeah, this is like $1 million or the billions of dollar market right now. Of course, there can be some also a misconfiguration of the security control, maybe some misconfiguration of all the procedures that, for example, someone in the CM alerted, someone in the security system alerted, but for example, some high level manager will not get this information. This is also a problem. Remember these lines between the IT and the security, there can be also a lower department, marketing department, all of this have to cooperate with each other. So in terms of the measure of the security, you have to get some kind of the tool, some kind of the procedure, just to count and measure this kind of the challenge of the organization. And this is, and this slide I really would like to you to remember, because this is like the creme de la creme of all of what I like would like to say to you, that you have to measure the security, not like a single one time, not a pen testing, not a some kind of the another test, maybe purple test, maybe red teaming. But this is not only about the one single test, but this is how to build a process to measure the security into the organization. Yeah. In the first step, you have to be sure that you create some kind of the baseline, you know your asset. On the second step, maybe not buy a new security environment, new security devices, new some brilliant stuff into your network, endpoint and email, but maybe optimize your security stuff, which actually you have established and trying to do change in some way and measure in some way the effectiveness of this security stock. On the other side, on the business side, so this is really interested part for your managers or SOC managers or a member of the board of your organization, that you can reduce cost of based on this. Yes, so we are not security into your new security stuff, but you are investment in the, I can say, a good way of using your existing environment. This is also quite a big challenge, but in terms of the, you know, investment and the save of the money, this is also important. And then automatize it, yeah? Then to try to monitor those changes, for example, what have been changed into your network. And you see this arrow, this is a continuous validation. It means that this is not like a one single test for your organization, but I really suggest it will be your strategy for your security development, just to validate the security, just to improve the security, learn on some kind of the maybe bad things you've done in the past, but learn, take some kind of the results and optimize your system, rationalize all of the security workflow, all of this security area, just to then monitor and then go back. Yeah, so check your asset and stuff like that. And I am pretty sure that in this you can of course use some kind of the external framework, because whenever you of course can use some kind of a tool like breach attack simulation or stuff like that, and Mandiant validation platform by far, this is one of the leader products on this market. But beside the products, beside the tools, I am pretty sure that you have some knowledge, you have to do some kind of the background, you have to do some kind of the review. So let's not use some kind of the commercial report. Let's go to the internet and check what's it's actually like open source. And right now you can, for example, use the NIST framework, or you can use the MITRE attack framework to it. Yeah, there's like 100 of different of techniques, procedure and tactics, which you can analyze, use, and maybe check if your network are ready for such kind of the attack. Because the idea of this non-profitable organization like NIST and MITRE ATT&CK is to share the knowledge. If the customer like you, maybe who have no budget to the information to buy some premium reports like Gartner, NSS Labs and Forrester, you can invest only your people and your time just to be sure that you are main protect, and use the open source framework. Yeah, I really strongly recommend you to go to the NIST site and see what are the recommendations of the security, and to go to the MITRE framework attack and try to check what are their recommendations, what, for example, APT groups they test in the past. It's free, so it's really good advice for your security people, especially right now in this, like I say, strange virtual time. You can like save some time and trying to learn based on this open source framework. And to summarize this presentation, this is the QR code for download the report, so you can scan this by your mobile. So I recommend it. The report, it's free, you have to only download it. I am pretty sure that you can do it now. This is my I can agree and can say you, this is not a malicious link. You can try to use your mobile phone to scan it. This report, I think in terms of the security, will be good for the security manager, but this report can be also good for your board member, or maybe only for the SOC analytics, for some technical engineers, just to be sure what are the trends. Yeah, and you can say and share this trends, you can share this knowledge also into your organization, because one of the like protest idea of the fire and also mind that is to share, because we are on the same side as you, we are on the bad or on the good side of the security, not on the bad side. So we are trying to also open source by free help you to covering all of this like attackers and hackers activity from many type of the world. So I am strongly recommended to use this kind of the report. So I am really appreciate to Dan on this event. Thank you for your participation. Thank you for your time. This is the second QR code which I recommended to use. This is my LinkedIn profile. So I think you can add me as a invitation for a LinkedIn whenever you have some question. We can discuss it like offline, so outside this conference on the LinkedIn, or we can of course maybe discuss it during the conversation. This is my avatar, so I am like in the middle of the front desk. I am not sure that I am really similar to this guy, but this is really me. So in terms of any question, the security validation or maybe like another FireEye product, you can find me on the stage and ask me directly some kind of the question. Yes, so okay, so thank you for your patience, and as always, stay healthy.
Damian, thank you very much for your presentation. We know where we can find you at the TDSoft promotion. We see your avatar, you look beautiful.
Yeah, thanks, great.
So thank you very much.
Thank you. See you.